We ain't making no gains with this food.
What up?
Hey guys!
What's going on?
I'm sorry we haven't been vlogging much lately.
Actually, I argued with Christopher yesterday. I wanted to do a...
Why are you so white?
Because I'm just white. I'm Casper.
No, we're like super white. What's up with the camera?
I don't know.
Hang on a minute. I'm just gonna have to deal with our pasty.
So, I bugged Christopher yesterday because it was our first wedding anniversary. And I wanted to do a vlog, and he said, no, Lee, that's boring. Us just sitting here talking, nobody wants to watch us. Just blab. Although that's pretty much all we do anyway.
I mean...
Just saying. We had a very full day. I got up first. Drove 2 hours to Charlottesville and 2 hours back. Because... Like, we had planned a big wedding, and then a lot of stuff happened with the business and whatever, and the timing just wasn't right, and we ended up having to cancel. And we canceled, what, like a month or two before the wedding?
Yeah.
So we'd had all our vendors picked out. I mean, we'd had the whole wedding planned, but wasn't meant to be. And so we eloped, and they gave us a little wedding cake, but it was like a vanilla on vanilla, like boring, nothing to it kind of thing. And so I contacted our cake vendor for the big wedding and asked her if she would last minute make us a small little mini version of what our wedding cake was supposed to be. And shout outs to Paris at Passion Flower Cakes. If you're in the DC area / Richmond area and you need a cake, dude, she's a rock star. But she made us an almond cake with alternating strawberry and raspberry buttercream, and it was phenomenal. And we had cake for lunch, and Christopher said, come sit down, I've got something to show you. This is your cue.
Hey guys.
You haven't been paying attention at all.
Yeah, I heard about the strawberry and raspberry. Okay. I even said it was bomb.com.
Yeah, and then I said we had the cake.
Yeah.
And you told me to come sit down on the couch. That video was so freaking amazing. I've watched it at least 5 times, no joke. I'm obsessed with it. It's really rare for Christopher to be like serious.
I'm always serious.
Like serious and like...
99.9% of the time I'm
sentimental and whatever, and he was in that video, and it just like killed me, dude. It still kills me. We had dinner at our favorite like upscale Italian place down on the walking mall. The chef actually came out, brought us peach bellinis, and sang to us in Italian.
White peach bellini. It was delicious.
Dude, I didn't even think I liked bellinis.
I don't even like peaches.
But it was so amazing.
It was
In fact, we should get some. We should get some of that stuff.
White peach bellini.
We're going to get some Five Guys for lunch. I'm slightly hungover. I need the grease.
Five Guys, burgers and fries. Look how white I am. Something's wrong with this camera today, man. Fix that. Oh, stop, Billy. Oh.
We'll be right back.
Stop. I just left a video because I have to clean the up.
You cussed.
God damn it.
Cussed again.
That doesn't count.
And you give me.
You cussed.
You should make a bet.
What bet?
A no cussing bet. First one to cuss has to what? I shouldn't leave this up to you.
Yeah, you should. Let's see here. If you cuss first, and you will, then you have to, you have to do my beard grooming every morning.
Are you sure? You zoomed in all the way. Are you sure you want to leave? You know what? I'll take that bet because you're leaving me.
You have to do it right, though.
You're leaving me responsible
for your beard. Right. My beard's gonna look up. Every morning for a week. Starting when? First person to cuss.
Okay, but if I win, what do I get?
I don't know. You haven't set the parameters. You like that word? Like I threw out the P word right there? Dude, you know what I got at Five Guys? They have the machines where you can like make your own, design your own drinks. So
the
you
Coke
get like
machines.
Sprite and then add like raspberry to it or orange to it, whatever. And I made cherry ginger ale.
I just got boring old Coke.
And it's freaking fantastic, and it's almost gone already.
But it's awesome for people like Chris, because he's got like a caffeine allergy. So they, you can make like any of the sodas caffeine free.
Yeah. We're going up in the CVS so I can get some cough
But we
drops.
Haven't established what I get if I win.
Yeah, like 3 minutes to think about it.
Okay. Be right back.
BRB, babies. BRB. We just went ham in CVS.
Dude, we are incapable of going into like a CVS or a Walgreens and spending less than $100. Like it just doesn't happen. Cause I have to get makeup.
I had to get all kinds of things for being sick. But you know what I found was some root beer throat lozenges.
He's very excited about this.
I'm very excited about that. I'll be sucking on some lozenges today.
Shop and save. So all of the Food Lions in town have become Shop and Save. And Chris and I are like, couldn't they have come up with a better name that sounds less bobo?
There's that.
Go on to the Shop and Save.
They should call it Chopair.
All right, so.
Chopair and Save.
That's taking it to a whole nother level. I did not figure out what I get if I win the bet.
You're supposed to decide, so you're disqualified. So now it's just me. If you cuss.
Well, then I can't win.
Well, then better think of something quick.
What would drive you crazy?
Excuse you? How about what would benefit you? How about you think about things that way? Is that where we are in our marriage?
Then it wouldn't be me. You have to...
We're gonna get hit.
You have to come get a pedi with me.
Oh. Oh yeah?
Yeah. Now I have to win.
Alright. You know, it's kind of not fair though.
Why?
Because pedis hurt my feet,
No,
man.
Baby, they don't. I'm not going to let them do the stuff to the bottom of your feet.
Lena.
I'll even give you my guy. You can have my guy.
They cut the hell out of my... When they did my nails, they cut the... out of my feet. I almost lost just there. I almost lost already.
But I'm going to make... I'm going to have my guy give you a pedicure. Not the other ones. Because my guy is like... Everything he does is like his masterpiece. He's so good. He takes his time, he's gentle, doesn't hurt.
Oh my word.
So Christopher this morning goes, hey Lee, pull this spare hair right here. So I go, okay.
I thought it was a hair that was just laying there that was not attached to my face.
No, it was attached to his face.
It was attached to my face.
So then he jerks away as I'm going for the second pull. And he's like, what are you doing? And I'm like, you told me to pull it.
Because I thought it was not attached. Once I realized it was attached. Dude. Abort. Abort mission.
Abort mission.
Abort mission. Once you realize that thing's attached, you abort mission, man.
That's great. That is excellent. It looked like some sort of exotic bird with like the blonde hair just kind of like sticking out over my head.
We're at work, guys.
See you later.
You know what? I put a brand new battery in there, and it's half dead already.
Really?
Yeah.
What up, you guys?
We just got some Taco Bell before we head to the gym.
Mm-hmm. And, I never eat Taco Bell with you.
No, she never does. Lena doesn't like cheese. So she gets to... She doesn't like cheese or sour cream.
Diablo.
Bam! So she gets the Fresco tacos.
Mm-hmm. Nothing.
They didn't give me... That guy even asked me, do you want some sauce? Man. Mess it up, Taco Bell.
So not car food.
Sure it is. Oh my goodness.
I'm making a mess. I'm fired. I need to use my napkin. Yeah, it's getting real over here.
Two tacos down.
Two?
Mm-hmm.
I'm only one.
I'm a third. We got some of these new rolled chicken rolled tacos.
Yeah. This is cheese.
Oh no, really?
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
They f***ed you up, man.
You cussed.
I'm not on video yet.
You are on camera.
But it's not going in.
You cussed. I win.
That's some bull. God damn it.
So the whole point of Taco Bell today was that we are trying their new, what are they called? Rolled chicken tacos?
Rolled chicken tacos, get one out.
Okay. Well, I gotta get my guac ready.
Yeah, but show them.
I'm gonna, ow. Well, I'll show
them. They're hot as hell.
Right before it goes in my mouth.
Rolled chicken tacos.
Yes, with some guac to dip it in. Alright, ready for
Dude,
this?
Dude, I am not. They're hot as hell.
Mmm.
They're good?
Mmm.
Really?
Yeah, man. They're like... Oof, I don't have... They're like... They're like chicken in a tortilla chip.
Mmm. Those are tasty. That's very different. I did not expect that.
Mmm.
Why do we keep going out of focus, man?
But the cool thing about these is that it's just chicken inside, so I can eat them. There's no cheese.
Yeah, there's no,
no beans.
Stuff in them.
No sour cream. You already lost. You might as well. So I can eat them, and then.
Whoa, sorry.
They have 6 different dipping sauces. They have spicy ranch, sour cream, nacho cheese, salsa, guac, and what's avocado ranch?
It's a spicy ranch. Come on, man.
These are pretty cool. They only come in 2 They're or good, 4 man. Though.
Mm-hmm. Maybe it needs to focus on your face. It's like not finding the faces.
Sorry guys, I'm getting my grub on. It's 6:30 p.m.
Excuse me.
And we're just eating for the first time today.
I really want to make an effort to vlog more.
Mm.
At some point, we will get to daily vlogs. At some point. But, we hate vlogging in the house because our house is such a damn mess. It's only because we're so damn busy.
And our dogs are. Those were interesting.
They're good, man.
But now that I've eaten them, I think two were good. I don't think I would want another one.
We ain't making no gains with this food.
So we are making tonight Christopher's favorite dish.
Steaming some rice, which is what?
Sorry. We're making some jasmine rice. I don't want my rings to fall. I could just put it back. Hold on.
Where you going, man? Look at that pantry. Our pantry is effed up, guys.
Yeah, it's
we need to clean this for reals.
Don't judge us. What?
Look at this mess.
What did I do with it? We do jasmine rice. This is Christopher's favorite. This is the kind. We use whatever jasmine rice we can find. But I did a cup of that and then 1 cup of water, 1 cup of chicken broth. Throw it in the rice cooker. Let it do its thing.
A little bit of protein in there. Just kidding.
And then.
For later. What is this dish called?
So this is, it's like a Cajun fried chicken.
Yeah.
With a lemon caper gravy / sauce, however thick you want to make it. But this actually started off from a recipe that was like wicked healthy. And then we did everything in our power to basically make it
unhealthy,
fattening as hell. So there's that. We haven't made this in a while, so.
I'll just film it as you go along.
We'll see how rusty I am, but we're gonna go ahead.
I need to slice up these chickens
and get this ready. Usually we use chicken tenders and it's a lot easier, but the store didn't have them.
So I'm gonna take these chicken breasts and slice them up and just basically make my own chicken tenders.
All right, so here's what we're doing.
Okay.
We've got flour.
Yeah.
We do breadcrumbs, panko.
Yeah.
And Italian.
A little mixture of the two, huh?
Yes.
Good stuff. Mix it right in there in the flour, huh?
And you wanna, you know, it's good to have extra because we use it in the sauce later.
Yeah.
Now, the thing with flour is that it absorbs flavor like you wouldn't believe. So you have to put a ton of seasoning.
So she's just gonna season it.
So, there's our garlic powder.
There's the garlic powder.
And you add to it, obviously, as you go. But you can tell.
What's just putting in there?
Cajun.
What's that? Let me see that.
We do like 20 different kinds of Cajun.
Yeah, we like a lot of different Cajuns.
This is Louisiana.
The Wheezy.
Fish fry products.
Let's not even go there. Let's not talk about fish.
I don't normally add salt to this simply because there's already so much salt in a lot of the seasonings that you don't need it. You can always do salt later if you need to.
What you got there?
Paprika.
Kind. The sweet kind, right? Sweet paprika?
I don't like this as much as you do.
They have the smoky one in there too. Oh, is that even the right one? Let me see. That is sweet. Okay. You don't like that one as much?
One of them I don't like very much.
The other one I think is not as good. It's the smoky one and it's a little overpowering.
Onion powder.
A little onion powder. Yeah, get some. What else you got going on there? Look at all them seasonings. What's this? Slap your mama. Heck yeah.
Here and is another Cajun.
Another Cajun.
Raging Cajun.
Turn that to your right just a tad. There you go. Look at that. There you go. Break that up. There you go.
Can't see how much is going in there.
You're getting it. I'm looking at it. You got a lot. It's good. That's real good. That's real good.
Blackened Cajun.
Some blackened. Why is my exposure so off? There you go. Blackened Cajun.
All right. Now, y'all don't have to put this much Cajun in it. Chris and I just
love Cajun.
Love Cajun. Love spices. So we can do a little bit more than the average person. So y'all don't have to go this crazy. A little bit of oregano.
A little oregano. Yeah.
How about a little Mrs. Dash?
Let's put a little Mrs. Dash in there.
Salt-free.
Salt-free.
We use
this one that wasn't, that had salt in it. Remember how like salty our food ended up being? We didn't know better. We learned that the hard way. Yeah. Dinner was interesting that night.
Yeah.
What else we got going on up in here?
Why don't you throw a little touch of that cayenne red pepper? Just a touch. Just a touch. Right there. Now, hold on before you do that. Open, just twist the lid off. Lid off. Just pour just a touch into the lid. There you go. Just a touch. That's good.
What's too much?
Nope, that's good. Bam.
What else we got?
What else you got? What else you gonna throw in? You got the kitchen sink we can put in there? You did garlic powder, right?
Yeah. I might do a little more actually.
You got the essentials, the garlic powder, the onion powder, the Cajun, and the paprika. Those are the essentials. Everything else is just additives.
When you know wanna know like how you're doing on spices, you can tell by the color. So once you mix all this up, we're gonna be able to tell by the color whether we're doing all right.
Yeah.
Or whether we need to get some more seasonings. Oh, I said I was gonna do more garlic. So this is nowhere near dark enough.
That's what she said.
So we're just gonna do this all over again. Oof. Whoa. Didn't realize it was open.
Yeah.
What are you doing, babe?
I'm opening up some Prosecco.
Why?
Because we're going to make some caprinhas. Actually, they're what? They're bellinis, right?
Bellinis.
But I can never think of that word, so I just say caprinha.
Why are we having bellinis?
Why are we having bellinis?
Where did we come up with this idea?
We had these at the Italian restaurant for our anniversary. And we were like, oh my god, we need to make these at home.
The chef / owner came out.
Ready?
And brought us. You're supposed to do it away.
Away?
Like, not at my face.
Woo! That just went everywhere. Everywhere. Damn! Contents under pressure right there.
Tried to kill me, man. Jesus!
Contents under pressure. Now I have to wipe up the floor.
And you were trying to open it on, like, towards my face. Tell me how you really feel, Christopher.
Holy smokes. I didn't know it was going to explode like that. Damn.
Clearly we don't drink champagne, ladies and gentlemen.
No, we do not.
All right.
What you got going on?
We're rocking and rolling.
I just chopped up them chickens.
Yep.
For Lena.
Throw it in the egg.
Oh, egg wash. Is that just egg or is anything?
Just egg.
Just egg.
Right into our seasoning.
Okay.
Let that bad boy chill. Extra.
What do you got going on in this pot pan?
Just oil.
Just extra virgin olive oil?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, to see it.
Is it already pre-warmed?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. This is our side dish. Green beans.
Green beans.
Just some seasonings.
I don't know why I'm doing like a country accent these days.
It's fun! Because we live in the country now.
Angle.
And just get all up in there.
That's a great angle.
Do you always do this with no shoes?
Don't get my toes, I need a pedicure.
Do you advise on wearing shoes while you do this? While you cook with hot oil, hot popping oil?
Yes.
Yeah.
And probably a long sleeve shirt too, but shit happens.
Stuff happens. Right? Stuff.
There we go. Alright. Alrighty then.
Right into the pan, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Just a nice thin layer of olive oil. Just gonna brown those up in the olive oil.
Mm-hmm.
All right, then.
We should have moved the chicken closer.
How are they coming along? Hmm? How are they coming along?
Good.
Nice and crusty.
You want to cook them on a high heat at first to get that crust to set. And then you can turn the heat down and just let them cook. But you want to watch them so they don't burn.
And then when you pull them off, you want to put them onto a plate with a paper towel, because this will absorb all the oil, so they won't get soggy. They'll get crispy. Right?
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah, they absorb the oil, so we're going to do this round with what we've got in there, and then once we take them off, we'll add some more oil.
Yeah.
Because you don't want them in the pot without anything, because then they will burn.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Rock on. What you got there?
They're coming off first round.
You got them chickens? They look so good.
You know when they're done because they're going to feel firm.
Feel firm?
Yeah, I just want these guys to have a good crust on them.
You like crust?
I do.
I like crust.
I love crust. Okay. All right, ready. So we pulled all our chicken off. Now we're going to make the sauce. So you're going to start with chicken broth.
Yep. Where you put it? You're putting it right in that
right
oil.
Right in there.
Okay, there was no oil left, or was there some oil left?
There's a little.
Just a touch, but it's all the scrap.
It's not a big deal, but you get all of the, like, yummy, like, chicken crispies. All you get on the bottom of the pan. We've already established I can't talk today.
How many drinks have we had?
Huh?
How many drinks have we had?
I haven't had that much. All right, so we did the chicken broth. I like to put in some white wine.
Yeah.
That's just me. If y'all don't like...
Do you have a choice, a preference, a choice?
I tend to drink...
What style? Chard?
I tend to drink tropical Chardonnays, so it actually works well, but like a drier white wine
would
do well.
And then... What do you do? Look at all them chicken scraps. And all the crusties and seasonings in there.
Add some lemon juice.
A little bit of lemon juice. A lot of bit of lemon juice.
And like I said, you do it to taste. So whatever works for you. All right. Now, what I like to do.
Yep. I can back up.
What I like to do, and I'm not the best at this, so sometimes it gets a little clumpy. But obviously you want to get all up in there. I should probably be using... a metal one.
There should probably be all up in there too.
But.
You want a metal one? Let me get you one. Do we have one?
It's hanging in there. And then with our extra flour, we like a thicker, more like a gravy.
That's the flour with all the seasonings, right?
Yep. This is our leftover flour. Just throw that in there. And it's gonna clump up.
Just try to work them clumps
so,
out.
Stir it up. And the longer it sits with the flour, the more flour there is and the longer it sits, it's going to naturally thicken up. So you can see how the color is changing.
Yeah.
It always gets a little clumpy.
Just work them clumps out. Ain't no thing but a chicken wing.
But it's all good. The original recipe did not say to use your flour, but... We don't follow the rules in this house.
Yeah, and it's already got the seasonings in it, so why wouldn't you?
This is what makes it more of like a Cajun gravy.
Look at that chicken clumps right there. Chicken clumps.
Yeah, man. See, that's you don't it. Need the perfect chicken strip because if you're clumsy like me and some of the seasoning comes off, that just means your gravy is going to be so much better.
You get bonus gravy.
It's actually okay. I always get, like, I always have a bunch of clumps in my gravy. And yeah. It doesn't matter because it actually ends up giving you, like, little bursts of flavor with all the seasonings and everything. So, we don't mind. My mom would probably die right now if she saw this. Because if you are, like, an actually, like, trained chef and whatever, what you're supposed to do is put the flour and, like, kind of stir it into... a roux,
yeah,
and then add all your liquid, but I'm not a chef. Sorry. Alright, we're gonna let this chill for a little bit.
Let it chill? What are these dogs doing? What are you doing, dogs?
They're not impressed.
Not at all. What's this? These, like, chicken scraps? I heard chicken scraps.
and heard there was chicken scraps. Bubba, look at him. What are you doing, scavenger? What are you doing, scavenger? Look at this. See this little thing right here? This little piece of a ball? Watch this. Yep. That's what she's playing with. She just wants that little piece of the ball. That's it. What you got going in there now?
Alright, so our sauce is thickened up a little bit.
Yeah.
Now for the final step, the capers.
This is
like the most important thing. Chris had actually never had capers before he had this dish. And they don't really, they look like peas, but they really are just salty. There's not really a whole lot to them. So you want to drain all the like vinegar or whatever it is that they pack them in and then just...
To me, capers taste salty.
Dump those bad boys in there.
Almost lemony, almost like a citrusy olive.
They were made for this dish, in other words.
Yeah, totally. So,
There you go, you guys. So to thicken the sauce a little bit, we actually raised the temperature up to boiling so that you could get the flour to kind of separate and merge a little bit with the liquid. And then we turned it back down to low and left it to just kind of...
sit and thicken.
Yeah, and we are ready to go.
Final product. Looking fantastic. Little spring mix with that.
All right, I gotta film you taking your first bite.
Well, that's gonna be a minute.
Okay. All right, Christopher, are you ready?
I'm ready. Christopher
likes to mash it all together.
I cut all the chickens up, and then I mash it, and get a big old bite. It's my first bite. My favorite dish in the world used to be manicotti my whole life. I'm Italian. This is taken over. This is my favorite dish.
You're just saying that. You don't have to say that.
No, for real. Don't be a jerk. This is my favorite dish in the world.
I don't put the gravy everywhere like he does. We've got just some...
this might be the best version yet.
Really?
It's got a lot of spice to it.
I did a good job?
Yeah.
Yes.
A lot of spice. The lemon is balanced really, really well.
Good.
It's just super, super flavorful. It's not over salted.
I didn't put any salt, actually. No salt, no pepper.
That's fantastic.
All right. Bon appetit.
Bon appetit.